What's worse? Girl, pick your poison.
Fendi and Adana, Karen, they be sharing all their money, got me wearing fly. Girl, my eyes.
Back your back. Yeah. Happy Monday. Oh, I forgot my hospital card. Oh, you got it? Show the lady. Not them. Ah! All right. What is going on? I know. Why you do that? Happy Monday. So I don't have any content scheduled today, so guess what's going on? You guys are gonna come spend the day with me shopping at Costco's. Why did I just look at myself and look like my cheeks were really big just now? I need to get on the scale, make sure I ain't gaining weight. You know, you can't see when you're gaining weight. At least I can't. I have to get on the scale. You can put it in my pocket.
Right here?
Yeah.
Okay. Look, you can put it in your pocket.
Okay.
You see me?
Put it in my pocket.
Because if you lose this one, it's not my fault.
You got to tuck down in there good.
Mom. If you lose this one, that's not my fault.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Mom?
I hear you.
We agree to this? We agree?
I hear you.
Okay.
All right, so I came at Costco's just to get two things, and I'm going to try to stick to it. I came to get a box of wipes, because it's so much more cost efficient for me to buy a whole box of wipes and a box of gloves. Ditto. What? Because we're close to Halloween. We're in July. No, we're not close to Halloween. July, August, September, October. Maybe like almost 3 months. But you know Costco, they like to get a jump start on the holidays. Okay, so which way did I see those gloves and stuff? I think it's over here.
They're the best type of hobby.
No, they're not. They're disgusting.
They taste so good, guys. I would mess them up
with that. Disgusting.
No. Oh, and Miss Vicky's. What the church says? Miss Vicky's?
Oh, Miss Vicky chips are pretty good.
You don't want to get one pack?
We were supposed to be in here for literally just wipes and gloves.
No, please, we don't have any snacks. Plus, Miss Vicky seems like a good option, except because of the Frito-Lay. Miss Vicky seems really good, guys. No, please.
All right, grab it.
Yes. Sea salt.
How much is that?
Oh, I don't know.
$18. It's not funny. Not funny. I didn't come in here to be spinning a whole grip. Not today. All right. Let's go. The wipes are right here. So bad. I just got off the phone with my daughter not too long ago, and she got her hair done. In like the kind of hairdo I got right now. And she told the young lady that she'll see her in 2 weeks. And I had to ask myself, like, you finna take these plaits out in 2 weeks, right? What's going on here? Am I like riding out too long? How long y'all leave y'all boho plaits in? Cause she making me think I'm like, I'm being a little bit extra. Why is this so heavy? Wait.
I took do it, look.
No. Don't get those. Get Rico brand.
Which one?
Right here. Yeah. Okay, come on. Listen, I know nobody ever heard of Rico brand wipes, but baby, I have never heard of the other ones. The Kirkland wipes.
You haven't?
Well, yeah, because Kirkland's, I guess, is this it's the store's brand. But listen, it gotta be just as fine as Kirkland's. Like, stop playing. And they're like $4 price difference. Okay, so anyway, Now let's find the gloves. I think the gloves gonna be on this other side over here. And since I'm here, I might as well get the big box of oatmeal. Don't you think, Paris?
Yeah.
All right. Let's see. I think it might be this aisle.
Yeah.
This aisle. Mm-hmm. I thought it would be this aisle. I probably need to ask somebody. You see him? Oh, there you go, right there. See right there, medium gloves. 400 gloves. Okay. All right. Now that that is out the way, we can possibly be out of here. What you spraying?
I'm spraying.
What is that?
Jo Malone with Tate T-Top.
Yeah, the mama brought her own perfume. Brought her perfume with her. Wood Sage and Sea Salt. What's she living? What she know about Wood Sage, Sea Salt, Jo Malone? All right. Oatmeal. That's what my next thing, right? This is fine.
Okay.
This is fine. I tried to get her the camera. She started making me feel all uncomfortable.
Because I didn't know what to reply. I was like,
grab the oatmeal from right there, B.
52 pack. Ooh, Costco has all the food.
You think I should get the fruit and the yogurt from here to make our yogurt bowls?
Yes.
Let's see. Just put it down already.
Yeah, now it's
I think I need to leave. I do. I'm not going to do this today. I'm out of here. No.
What about
I think we're fine. I'm not grabbing anything else out of this joint. It's a trick.
Ooh, what about we make chocolate covered
strawberries? Mm-mm. Ooh, they have Skittle
fruit snacks. That's crazy. And it's made with real fruit
here. All right, so we can either do self-checkout. No. Can I tell y'all something? I used to shop at Walmart, right? Because I feel like the prices were cheaper. Okay, wait a minute. Where are you going? Let's go here. Line is shorter. Yeah, the line is shorter. Okay. So I used to shop at Walmart because I felt like my money went longer at Walmart. But I did not like it there. Let me tell you why I ain't like it there, for one. It was no help up in that store. Like, I'd rather pay more money and get help. Like, get a conversation at the cash register. Somebody's being... No. Oh, we do. Okay. Go ahead. Put it up here. Okay. Why I'm acting like I don't know what I'm doing? Because I'm talking to y'all. That's why. Now you see all this stuff up here? I told you that you could have got out of here and you wanted to go to Dunkin' Donuts.
Their stuff is so oily. It makes my stomach hurt. Especially their pizza.
The Costco pizza is the bomb. What you mean? It is absolutely delicious. Okay, so I was talking about why I stopped shopping at Walmart. Okay, so my money did go longer at Walmart, but it was the fact that I had to do everything myself. You could barely find any help if you couldn't find anything. Then you had to bag your own grocery, put your own stuff inside the buggy. And when I go to Publix,
you can go ahead.
Okay, no problem.
Oh, it's slow.
When I go to Publix, you got all the help. People so eager to help you to find stuff. They talking at the register. How was your day? What new movies are out? You know, like, what do you recommend? And I'm like, I don't know. What do you recommend? So we're having those kind of conversations at the register. And so the reason why I got into that conversation is because parents like to do self-checkout. Everywhere we go, she wants a self-checkout. I don't pay for that. I don't want to do self-checkout. I want somebody else to check me out. I want to do as less work as possible when I'm at a place spending my money. So, like just now, she wanted us to do self-checkout at Costco. I was like, God, please, I don't want to pick up this stuff. Thank you. So, yeah. So with that being said, I guess I would rather spend more money and have good service, huh? Whatever. All right, so that was pretty quick. I restrained myself from buying stuff that I absolutely did not need, and that's a plus.
Oh man.
Oh man. All right, so I still got a couple of more things I gotta do. I need to go by Glenn Stocker's office, because I could barely get them on the phone. Come on, Pete, let's go. All right, so I am here at the doctor's office. And apparently, I cannot get a refill, a new script on Glenn's medication. So Glenn takes baclofen. It's a muscle relaxer because he's really spastic. And the script usually lasts for a year. So we're out, and they said I can't get a new one until he's seen by the doctor, which is cool, you know. So now I gotta wait and get an appointment for him to get seen in order for him to write the new script. So yeah, that's where we at. I'm gonna get this to-do list done today, though. Everything that's on that list, I'm gonna get it done, and once I finish with that list, then I'll move on to some other things. But on other news, I think I have been definitely going through a transitional period spiritually. And the reason why I say that is because I've been real uneasy. And the uneasiness, it's no apparent reason that I know that is happening in my life that I can see that's causing me the uneasiness. But I can tell something is going on because I'm shopping excessively. And I don't do that because I'm a really good saver. But I have been finding myself buying things that I don't necessarily need, but I want, you know, like another a bottle of perfume that I really don't need because I have tons of perfume, or a pair of shoes that I really don't need because I got tons of shoes. But, you know, just doing some excessive shopping. And usually when I do that kind of stuff, it's because something is going on with me and I'm trying to feel better. Baby, I don't need to spend money like that. So I've been praying, spending more time with God, trying to figure out what's going on with me. Why am I feeling this uneasiness? So that I can stop spending. But anyway, I'm going to stop spending, period. I'm not going to do that. While I'm waiting on God, I'm still going to cut that spinning, because it ain't making me feel no better. I get the stuff home and then I'm like, yeah, I got it, put it on the shelf. Brings no satisfaction. It don't lessen up the grip that's on my head. But so I'm definitely gonna stop doing that and see what's happening. I believe I just need to get a little bit more more intimate with God, praying a little bit more, reading my word a little bit more, and I think the uneasiness a lift. Yeah. Oh yeah, that's what's been going on. It's definitely not anything I can see that's going on in my everyday life that's making me feel like this. But we're gonna stop spending for sure. All right, so we left off at, I got Glenn a doctor's appointment. After the doctor's appointment, then he will go ahead and prescribe what he needs. And we did that. And I stopped over here to Smoothie King and got me a shake. I haven't had one of these in a long time. So I got a nutty super grain. You can find these on the vegan menu. It's really good. And
I'm trying to decide whether I'm going to go to the gym. I really, really don't want to go at all. But I feel like I need to go. I'm going to try to go ahead and get in here and do at least 30 minutes in here. Because I haven't been in here in a minute. So I think I'm going to try to do 30 minutes. I think what's really making me not want to go in here is that my phone almost dead. So I can't even listen to Stephanie Aiko. I think that's how you pronounce her name. But I would listen to her, listen to some of her her messages while I work out. And I can't even listen to them. My phone is only on 17%. It's not going to last. I mean, it is no motivation to make me want to go in here and go work out. So, I don't know. I'm going to see if I can just push myself and just go ahead and just and get at least 30 minutes in. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, that's where I'm at with that. So as I'm sitting here drinking my smoothie, my mind, I'm saying to myself, I would much rather like to go to TJ Maxx and just walk around. I would much rather like to go to TJ Maxx. But can I make it out of there without purchasing anything is the question. And I probably can't, not right now. I know the best thing for me to do is to not even finish my shake. Because if I sit here and finish this shake, I'm going to have more time to talk myself out of going to the gym. Do it. I was working up a sweat now, but working up this sweat, right? So now I'm like sweating in my head. I'm going to put my weight up, and I see a couple of people like kind of staring at me. This is why they're staring at me. Look at this. Obviously, I didn't rinse all that hair color out of my head, and now it's running. Child, you know what, y'all. Ladies, I don't know. I'm just trying to, like, why y'all ain't come up to a girl and be like, girl, your rinse. Here go a paper towel, mama. Wipe your face. Everybody just stared like, girl, you got black stuff running down your face. Well, anyway, I'm glad I went on and did that. I put my smoothie on this ice inside of my jug. So it kept it pretty froze while I went and worked out. Well, I'm glad I pushed. I did 100 deadlifts and I did 4 sets of 20 curls. And I don't know what you call this one. Well, you that one, but I did 4 sets of 20 for that. And that did my 30 minutes. And so I'm gonna go home, go take me a good bath. And I don't know. I'll go take a good bath and go fold up these clothes that I got in the house. That's what I'm about to do. All right, I gotta go. My favorite vlogger has came on. I hope I'm your favorite vlogger, but my favorite vlogger has just came on, and I'm gonna watch her. Go, Peyton. Go. Hey. Good morning, y'all. How y'all doing? How your mama doing? Good morning. I had an awful night's sleep last night. I mean, just awful. I was, did I put the coffee in here? I know y'all hear my machine going. What is a new one? But I had to wash early this morning. I'm sorry if it's making too much noise. But yeah, I had an awful night's sleep last night. My husband's primary care was talking to him about good kidney, liver health and all that stuff, and he mentioned not to take too many like Tylenol, Motrin and all that stuff. And I thought about it. I take like Tylenol PM, Advil PM almost every other night to help get sleep. And so I was like, man, I'm not taking that if he's saying it's like it's bad for kidney, liver health. So last night I went to sleep without taking it, and oh my god, when I tell you I was up all night. The worst night's sleep. Oh my god, the worst night's sleep. I don't know, but I thought to myself, I say, listen, girl, what's worse? Kidney, liver damage, not sleeping all that well at night, because it can't keep going on. Eventually my body gonna get used to going to bed on its own, but what's worse? Girl, pick your poison. So yeah, that was that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go and get some melatonin later today and see if that will help. Melatonin or some magnesium. Let me see. You know, see, would that help me get a better night's sleep? Yeah, so anyway, I'm fixing my husband a cup of coffee this morning because yesterday, I went out on the patio with him on the backyard, and we had coffee, and we just talked, like what we do every other morning, not all the time, but we do it every other morning, but I think we had such a good conversation yesterday morning. He came in the house, I'm trying to do other stuff, he's like, hey, where you at? Bad, I put the chairs out, I put the table out, where's the coffee in the conversation? I'm like, oh. All right, boys, I'm coming right now. So, let me go have a little talk with my baby. I hope this is sweet enough. Yeah, that's sweet enough. And, go outside and have morning coffee with my baby. But we're going to get back to coffee. We're going to talk. Because I believe y'all is like my therapist. Because I get on here and I talk. And sometimes I can talk it out and I feel a little bit better. But it's not them. It's me. It's got to be me. It's not everybody else that I'm encountering. It has got to be me and some stuff I need to fix in my life. I know I got a problem with being told no. And that's got to change. Because, baby, everything is not going to go your way, kid. Get it together. All right, let me go take my husband his coffee.
That's it. What do you guys have to drink?
We ordered drinks already.
Oh, yeah. We already ordered drinks.
That's it.
Yeah.
No, get lunch at Sushi Sake. Probably won't be open long because
chicken and shrimp fried rice. The chicken fried rice and then my view of the breakfast.
Yes, that's correct. Okay.
But yeah, so I had lunch and then I'm just going to kind of prepare for this wedding. Yeah, I got a wedding that I have to do. My aunt is getting married. I got to do the makeup for the wedding. So, yeah, so I'm going to prepare for the wedding.
Yeah, we had too much going on. I couldn't do it.
Decided to stop and come get something to eat. Isn't she pretty?
She's gonna blow.
Why are you looking like that, Mom?
Well, I can see what they do. I'm over here on this side and I don't know what the heck is going on. Can you see me or you can't see me?
I can see you.
We can switch, Grandma.
Yeah, so we getting breakfast at First Watch. And then we're going to go home and finish her hair and stuff for her sister's wedding. My baby sister getting married. So she came to get glammed up, get her hair and her eyelashes and stuff done. All right, so we're going to eat breakfast and we'll see. Megan, I love it. All right.